A gross story from New York City, where a woman was at a subway station sitting on a bench when a man suddenly hit her in the face with human feces.
Oh, that's the worst thing to be hit with.
Damn, who hits
that, homie? Oh, I like to hit you right in the head.
Misha, cancel the Milky Way.
The feces-throwing person got away, and hopefully the woman got a shower.
You hit me with poop.
Well, I was going to say, this guy over here. Oh. I mean, do you even continue living at that point?
You catch a body, right? Take a life.
Yeah, in the face. She got hit in the face with human feces. If I got hit in the face, I would... I'm trying to think if I would look for something to wash it off first before I killed the person. I would probably dive on the person. I would run after them so quickly, and I would strangle them. They would be dead within 20 seconds. Their neck.
You'd see a head come off of a body.
Yeah.
The way an angry girl breaks a doll's head off the shoulders.
New York.
Oh, that's so gross. And I guess there's no better poop in any better region, all right?
Apparently, you can't even ride the subway anymore. Like, there's crime constantly now.
The whole world is just crime.
It's all going to hell.
People are getting pushed in front of the subway every day.
It's
not New York, but in L.A. when they started looting the trains.
Uh-huh.
They found out that these trains had all the Amazon packages on them, so they were just looting all of the trains.
Like a post-apocalyptic movie.
So from there, I started following all of these Instagram accounts about Los Angeles, gutter people of Los Angeles, called. And I don't know if it's just because I'm being inundated with images of it now that I think it's bad.
It's so bad.
Like, Los Angeles... Like I said, maybe it's not that bad, and I'm just seeing it, so it makes it seem like it's really bad.
No, it sucks.
It seems like it's really bad right now.
Misha, remind me. I'm going to call my buddy Jake Weissman. Jake was a guy that I've stayed in touch with that I did stand up out west with, and he was just a sweetheart of a guy. He was one of the first people that kind of gave me a lay of the land. Here's an open mic. Here's a showcase. Yada, yada. We've stayed in touch. He... We'll send photos of stuff. Have you ever been into downtown L.A.? L.A.'s not much of a big urban area.
I've never been to Los Angeles.
You ain't missing much. It's five cities crowded on top of each other to make one big city. But downtown, officially downtown L.A.,
right, where all the big buildings
is horrifyingly decaying. It's not pretty. There's no glitz. There's no glamour. It is rot. It is tense. It is transient.
Well, there's Skid Row, but it's like Skid Row has just ballooned out of control.
Oh, Skid Row's everywhere now. Even when I was there 10, 12 years ago, downtown was to be avoided, more so than Baltimore. Not because of those gun battles and stuff. It's just crazies. And Jake says it's chaos now. Like clubs we would go to do stand-up, the Hollywood Bar and Grill, you don't go there anymore. There's a tent encampment in the parking lot. A place where I used to park my 2002 Hyundai Sonata, there is now a 10-person heroin fart tent.
Yeah.
It's all gone out in the tracks. Josh, look up the tracks of where these trains are being raided.
Oh, is it going to upset me?
Well, remember they had that map about San Francisco of where there was human feces
in the
city?
It's just now San Francisco.
Remember that? If you were going there, you could try to avoid the human feces by going to this map where they posted all of the... Because all the homeless people just crap all over the sidewalks and stuff.
That's not an app that should be needed.
No, it's disgusting.
But it's needed. Yeah, it ain't good on the coasts right now.
Got to move to Montana.
Yeah, baby. I'm always talking about Dakota. We're going to build a container village. Me? Put me in a wig, man. Rename me. You can call me Clarice.
We'll give Spiegel the big bedroom. He has his own. I'll do a lot of the cooking if you'd like.
I'll clean.
He can clean.
I know a little something about home defense. I'll take first watch.
We'll have scheduled sexual... we will service each other on a regular basis.
Jeez. Yeah, we ain't no women folk in this thing.
No, hell no.
Me? Hell no. Just a bunch of dudes in the woods. Okay, can I ask him the same question, Josh?
Mm-hmm.
What happens? Somebody hits Scott with a piece of poop. What does Scott do?
Nothing.
If you got hit with a piece of poop?
Nothing.
I think I freeze.
I wash my face off. I keep it moving. Hope they get arrested. What am I going to do? It's fine. I don't care.
I would care.
I mean, I would care, but I mean, what do you do? What do you do?
I don't decapitate
you've
someone.
You've had a child. You've had feces all
yeah,
over you.
Yeah, but it's sort of my poop. His poop is my poop. But if I get a stranger that throws, walks up and does that to me, I think I love the term vapor lock, where I think I freeze in position and multiple cycles of day and night happen before I start moving again.
Speaks goes immediate rage.
Yeah. I mean, if I can't catch, well, I'd have to decide whether to strangle them or to push them in front of a train. I would have to make that decision.
Yeah, and it's hard to do when you've got, you know, fecal on your face.
Yeah, I'd have to wipe it out of my eyes.
If it landed anywhere near my mouth, I try and break my own neck.
Yeah.
I just take my head and I just wrench it to the side and be like, well, daddy had a good run. Tell Evan I love him. And then just tip over.